this video, we want to look at congenital rubella syndrome. Okay. So basically, this is caused by what? Rubella virus. Okay. Rubella virus. Have you seen rubella virus? Basically, it is an RNA virus. You have seen in the classification already. It is an RNA virus. It belongs to Toga viridae. Okay. So this, it's an RNA virus. Remember, it's Toga viridae. It's a separate family altogether. It causes very similar rashes, very similar to measles virus. Okay, this is measles, guys. This is measles. But our focus today is on rubella. So, it causes similar type of exanthema. Okay. And this is rubella virus. Look at the morphology of rubella virus. You have typical single-stranded RNA here. Right, and then you have matrix, you have nucleocapsid, then you have envelope, then you have these glycoproteins attached to the envelope. Very standard of all the viruses that you have seen so far. Nothing special here except that the glycoproteins are named as E1 and E2. Okay, that's the only thing probably you have to know here. Everything else is same. Single-stranded RNA, you know it's an RNA virus, single-stranded RNA. And it can has an envelope. Envelope is always lipid to which glycoproteins are attached. Here it is E1, E2. Rubella, E1, E2, you remember something like that. It has only one serotype, only humans are the reservoir. Very simple story it has. So basically, rubella causes congenital infection. This is the most problematic one, okay? Postnatal, like when another, after birth, sometime you acquire it, like a neonatal can get it, or a child can get it, or even an adult can get it. But this is a self-limiting condition. Okay, this is a self-limiting condition. It is not very life-threatening. But the problem here is the congenital infection, because it is teratogenic, right? So, if mother gets it, it causes anomalies in the fetus. So, that is where it becomes a teratogen. It is it causes congenital rubella syndrome. So, which is what we are going to look at today. So, basically, there is something called as torch complex. Torch complex is nothing but, it is just abbreviated as torch. It, all the agents that cause congenital infection, like toxoplasma, right? Toxoplasma is a parasite, right? Varicella, virus, syphilis. Syphilis is what? Bacteria. That is Treponema pallidum, rubella virus, cytomegalovirus, which is also a herpes virus. Then you have herpes simplex virus. So all these you have to know. T for toxoplasma, O for others like varicella, syphilis, that is Treponema pallidum. R is what? Rubella virus. C is cytomegalovirus, which is also a herpes virus only, and herpes simplex virus. Okay. So guys, are you understanding that in this torch, R stands for rubella. This is what we are focusing on today, right? Focusing today on rubella virus. Congenital rubella syndrome is what we are looking at, right? So congenital rubella syndrome is what we want to look at. So basically, it is a teratogen. As we told you, it's a teratogen, right? So we need to learn more about this. It's a more serious consequence of rubella virus infection, okay? Especially if the mother acquires the virus during the first trimester of pregnancy. In first trimester, if she gets, then that will become the most problematic. There is high risk, okay? After 5 months of pregnancy, it is not that problematic, okay? Outcome of fetus, you know, it can either lead to a miscarriage, or the fetus can die, or there can be premature birth, right? With congenital defects. So this much you have understood, right? So if the mother gets it in first trimester only, it is problematic. After that, it is having low risk. Okay, at least that much you remember. Now let us look at the clinical conditions. What actually happens to the baby? The baby can actually, the fetus can die, or it can be born prematurely with congenital defects. There can be a miscarriage, etc. Now coming to congenital rubella. Let's look at the clinical features. Are you okay? What are we studying? Rubella, congenital rubella syndrome. It's caused by rubella virus. Which is what? An RNA virus. What else you know about it? Okay. So let's go to congenital rubella. The clinical features. Permanent damage, what and all will happen. Basically here, CNS microcephaly. You can see a microcephaly here, right? A microcephaly. Mental retardation, motor delay, autism. That is what has been mentioned here. CNS defects. All these are permanent, okay? And then there's something called as classical triad, which consists of ear defect, ocular defects, and cardiac defect. These together are called as triad, classical triad, okay? So, let's focus on this. Here they're saying ear, right? Ear will have sensory neural deafness. So, the person has sensory neural deafness. So, sensory neural deafness means here, something to do with the nerve, right?
Well, it says neural, so something to do with the nerve. Ocular defects here, there could be salt and pepper retinopathy. So look at this eye, some salt and pepper kind of a feeling. Where will you see this? Rubella, remember. One more thing they have mentioned is cataract. Here they are showing cataract in the baby. Cardiac defects, now this is also permanent cardiac defect where there is patent ductus arteriosus. Patent ductus arteriosus, this one. Patent ductus arteriosus here between the aorta and the pulmonary artery, right? So actually this ductus arteriosus has to close by itself after birth, but here it's remaining open, okay? That's what we think. Next is ventricular septal defect can be there. So this is the right ventricle, this is the left ventricle. Between these two, some septal defect can be there, which is permanent. It comes under the permanent lesions of congenital rubella. So we have looked at all the permanent lesions: sensory neural deafness, salt pepper retinopathy, cataract, patent ductus arteriosus, ventricular septal defect, and also one is there here, pulmonary artery stenosis. So this pulmonary artery, which is here, guys, pay attention here. This is the pulmonary artery, right? This can get stenosed, okay? Then you can have microcephaly, mental retardation, motor delay, autism. Now let's move on to the transient congenital changes. So these are not permanent, they are saying. Hepatosplenomegaly, bone lesions. See, these two are easy. You can remember these two. Intrauterine growth retardation will be there. So the baby is not growing up to the mark. Probably it can grow once it comes outside. So it is transient. Then there can be thrombocytopenia with petechiae. So there is some kind of a less platelets. Thrombocytopenia, platelets are less. So if platelets are less, what will happen? Blood won't clot. So there are petechiae here and it's called as blueberry muffin syndrome. This is the photograph found from internet. So blueberry muffin syndrome. Okay. So guys, hope congenital rubella you have understood. Let's take a recap. Rubella virus causes it. Rubella virus is an RNA virus, toga viridis, and it is very similar to measles in the type of exanthema in childhood that it produces. But here we are not talking about childhood one, we are talking about the congenital one, right? So it is highly teratogenic. Remember the glycoproteins here are called E1 and E2. It causes congenital infection, teratogenic it is. So if the mother gets this rubella virus infection in the first trimester, it is going to be very high risk. The outcome may be miscarriage, fetal death or premature birth weight with congenital defects. What will be the congenital defects? Permanent defects can be the sensory neural deafness, salt pepper retinopathy, cataract. With the heart, you can say three things. Patent ductus arteriosus, ventricular septal defect, and pulmonary stenosis, pulmonary artery stenosis. Three things in the heart. And in CNS, there can be microcephaly. Okay, they are talking about a triad. Triad is including only the ear, eye, and the eye. Ear, eye, and the heart. Note that all these are permanent. And now coming to transient, they are saying intrauterine growth will be less. But the hepatosplenomegaly will be there. Spleen will be big, liver will be big. Bone lesions can be there. Thrombocytopenia with petechiae, it's called as blueberry muffin syndrome. Okay, that's all for now. Bye-bye.